evening. I'm Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and we welcome you to the Thomas and Mack Center just off the Vegas Strip for our main event of the evening. 12 rounds in the bantamweight division. We are looking forward to this fight, especially after seeing what happened at the weigh-in yesterday. A stare down that nearly resulted in a bout breaking out right there. Now they get to do it for real. His poise is one of those things that cannot be denied. This is a very confident fighter. Gonzalez is so alert right now. I mean, look at his focus as he makes that walk that so many fighters dread. But he makes that walk down to the ring just so very alert.
All right, fellas, let's have a good, clean fight. Touch them up and let's go.
When you get a fight like this that everybody's been talking about, it's always so interesting to see these opening moments here in round number one. Gonzalez is showing that he's got some defense of his own. He got away from that punch. Teddy, through the history of the sport, this is one of the matchups that has produced some of the more interesting fights, especially in the lower weight classes, speed versus speed.
Who's going to be the guy that uses speed better? Who's going to be able to time shots and control range? That's what I'm looking at.
Parries that punch intended for the head. Gonzalez's defense did a good job there, able to avoid that punch. Teddy, he did a smart thing right there. Just created enough space and then landed the counterpunch.
Looked like the will of the wisps, the old great Willie Pep. Made him miss, made him pay.
Hey, gotta see
Gonzalez's
that
punch
go.
Is far off the target. Halfway through this round.
Work the body!
We've talked about this time and time again. When you get these two mentalities squaring off against each other, it should be a brawl.
Yeah, the old timers would say about these guys, they get insulted if you miss them.
On the mark, the counterpunch by Chico. What a trap he just set, and he lands a nice counterpunch.
Yeah, that's the old Casper the Ghost trick there. You know, you're there one time, you give him a little shade, you know, a little shadow, and then he throws at you, you pull back, bang, come right back with your own.
Last 10 seconds. Able to dismiss it. They both decide to bring it. Gonzalez has got to wake up to the fact that he just lost that last round. And the reason he did was because he wasn't efficient. He wasn't accurate. Yeah, he was throwing punches. He wasn't landing many.
No, he's throwing them from too far away. They're too wide. He needs to shorten them up, get into better range, and use that jab as a finder.
I need to see some counter punches, okay? Whatever he misses, counter.
There you go.
Keep your hands moving, keep busy, and you'll beat him to the punch.
Here we go, round two is underway. Blocks that punch.
Protect yourself!
Keeping his hands up, getting way of his opponent's effort. Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. Chico's tagged by a hook.
Where's the body, kid? Call these shots!
Way to block there. That uppercut absolutely rocked him. Boy, I don't like the way his legs look at all right now. Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. Any seconds to go here in this round. That right hand serving him well.
Uppercut! Uppercut!
Keep moving!
Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. Parries that punch away. Chico's got a little something coming back at him. A counter punch scored. Combo lands to the head. Heading into this fight, we talked about what each man can do offensively, what each man wants to do is have varied punches throughout.
Exactly, and what he doesn't want to do. He doesn't want to be predictable.
Good defensive skill with the block by Chico. Final 10 seconds of round number two. Chico's got that look. He's got that look like, hey, I know exactly why I had success in that last round. He was able to stun his man, Teddy.
Yeah, you can see that confidence, that body language. Now it's up to an adjustment from his opponent.
How you doing? You okay? I need you to use your feet. Move around the ring. You got that? Okay, let's go.
Yeah, we'll get him, we'll get him.
Well, he got caught by a lucky punch in that last round. It did do some damage, but now you can tell he's right back where he wants to be, fresh and ready as we start this round.
I don't take lightly when a guy gets dropped, but you know what? I think he was more embarrassed than he was hurt.
Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head.
Nice work!
One, two. Watch that.
That was a fine block by Chico. Chico's showing you a little defensive skill there, able to move away from that punch. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. Great counter punch, and I loved how he moved off to the side and then landed it. Well, he's trying to keep up a heck of a work rate here. Gonzalez is punching himself out at this point.
Yeah, and that's not the worst part of it. The worst part of it is going to be if his opponent notices. He's working the body.
Chico's in a bad spot right now. He's been stunned. Boy, I know he's not in great shape, but all of a sudden he's doing a very good... Did you see that? What a hook to the body, and he is down and in bad shape.
One, two, three, four, five.
Gonzalez is able to get up. Teddy, I question, though, if he'll be able to go on. What does he have to do?
Well, he's got to know what to do, but what not to do. Don't use your legs. Don't try to move because that's the inclination. Get on your bicycle when you've been hurt. No, the bicycle's not there. You got flat tires. What you got to do is grab on the inside, clear your head.
This is your night. Keep closing the gap. When you get too close to him, fast combinations to the body. Bien rapidito. He doesn't like those shots to the body.
I'll throw that away.
You gotta pick up the speed, all right? Pick up the speed.
Round number four underway, a chance to look at Teddy's scorecard. Chico's recuperative abilities being tested to the limit here. Just 60 seconds to gather yourself after being knocked down in the last round.
Now, we talk about the fighter, but it's important right now for the corner, for the referee, for the doctor to know that he does have those kind of recuperative powers. So they give him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe the ref gives him a little more time than he gives somebody else.
That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Gotta love the work by Gonzalez. Not able to connect with the uppercut.
There you go.
Move your head.
Seconds to go in round number four. To the head he goes with a left hand.
Work the body, kid. Body shot.
Beat him to the body.
Uppercut.
are doing great!
He just missed that shot up top. Dismisses his opponent's headshot. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. Great job of protecting himself. He's keeping his guard up very, very well. Teddy, does it help to have the speed that he has?
Sure. Anytime you have speed and you can put it into the equation where whatever you're doing, it has to be technically right, but now you put speed, you're doing it even better. You're doing it at a higher level.
10 seconds remaining in this round. And round four comes to an end. Gonzalez is missing punches. I mean, there's just no way to sugarcoat it. His accuracy isn't there.
And there's a reason for it, Joe. His punches are the wide variety. And wide punches, guess what? They don't find the mark. They're not accurate.
That's it. Relax. Just like
we got
that.
It.
Another round like that. He doesn't like those body shots. He doesn't like that kick, okay? Keep working the body.
And we are back underway, another round in a fight that's been very entertaining, but I wouldn't want to be a judge. This is one of those fights that could go either way. Missed the body shot.
1-2, 1-2, one of those, you got this one. Keep moving.
Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time him, he can counter him.
Let it go!
Able to dismiss his opponent's shot, and then comes back with an uppercut. And just grabbing on to his opponent.
I love.
You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there.
Looking good.
And coming upon the halfway mark of this 3-minute round.
Get in there! Get in there! Keep moving!
You're still not moving enough! Move!
Double up your punches!
He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. Chico's missing punches here. Now the good news. Oh, that uppercut got him badly.
Wake up!
Somehow he's avoiding going down here. All of a sudden, some good defense after a lack of it cost him. Comes right back with some offense of his own. Didn't get it done going to the body there. Coming to the end of round number five, last 10 seconds.
Relax. You're okay. Keep your hands up. Keep them up. He caught you with your hands down. Keep them up.
Throw that away.
You need to move your head more, okay? Side to side. Lean to the side. Boom. Count punch. Listen, I'm not gonna stand here and watch you take those shots, you understand me? Let's see some defense and more punches.
Back underway here to live fight action. Tough fight to score. Very, very even. Closely contested bout throughout.
Side to side.
Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot.
There you go.
And now just wasting away some time with that clinch. Chico's on the receiving end of a very good counterpunch. Gonzalez is hit by a right hand. He turned things around, and now his opponent has to be asking himself questions.
Yeah, he's got to be saying, what do I have to do to get rid of this guy?
Blocks the headshot.
Beat him to the punch! You're doing great!
He's showing very good footwork. He's showing fine defensive movement here. But as for the opponent, how do you solve that?
Well, you got to make believe you're a football player. You got to make believe you're a lineman.
Can you believe? Wow! What a turn of events! What a turnaround! He scores his own knockdown after being knocked down earlier.
And that's where scoring a knockdown hurts you sometimes, because now you think you're just going to walk in and get it again. Well, he walked in. He did get it. He got it.
Not getting it done with that straight right hand.
Keep moving. Gotta be Zito, son.
Oh, what a whiff by Chico.
Relax, relax.
He had his eyes set on the uppercut, but was unable to land it. Final 10 seconds of the sixth round.
Keep that head moving.
Went to the body there, but unable to connect. A very fan-friendly round, but a headache for the judges. How do you possibly score that round when each man was able to hurt the other?
Well, this is where you have to be a good judge. You have to be a professional judge. You have to use the information that's there. Who won the spots of the round before they each hurt each other? And who hurt the other guy a little more?
He can't be first. When he throws first, he's able to set that power shot.
Yeah, we'll get him, we'll get him.
I need you to keep moving this round. Stay on your feet.
And we are underway with the second half of this fight. Able to cover up along the belt line, blocks that one. Good step back, counter punch there.
Beautiful.
Where's the body?
missed that uppercut. Chico's opponent knows exactly what the game plan can be now. That counter punch landed with some success. Gonzalez has got to be moving more than this, Teddy. I mean, you cannot win a fight just standing stationary like this.
Well, you know, if his opponent could have, he would have gotten him to sign a contract and say, hey, I want you to stand right in front of me all night long so I can do whatever I want. And he's doing whatever he wants.
Halfway through the seventh round.
Get in there!
Off to the side, a little swing and a miss going upstairs. And he ties up on the inside.
Uppercut! Uppercut!
And now just wasting everybody's time holding on.
You're taking too much punches! Hands up!
Chico's able to avoid that punch. Boy, some of the old school guys would really appreciate this, wouldn't they, Teddy? Just great upper body movement, so elusive up top.
Yeah, this is an example like they used to say in old days. He stands right in front of you and you can't hit him in the backside with a handful of buckshot.
I want another round like that. This is your fight, okay? You're in complete control of this fight. Don't let him breathe. It's hurt.
We got it.
You know, they call them the championship rounds for a reason, and we're not quite there yet. Just about halfway through this fight. Here, round number 8 underway, and he's up on your scorecard, Teddy, but the toughest test is yet to come.
Yeah, it's kind of like a doctor. You know, he's been working the rounds all day long, but now it becomes the nighttime. You know, the emergency cases are going to come in and stuff. Can he keep that concentration? Can he take care of the patients at the same level he did earlier in the day?
Gonzalez has been stunned. Oh, he's hurt right there. He is hurt.
Joe, in this kind of situation, it's kind of like a wounded animal. Yeah, you can go after, but you better be careful because he'll strike out when you don't expect it.
Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head. Big, big shot comes crashing home. And once again, he goes down. The question is, can he rise up again? Gonzalez is back up on his feet. Let's see what he has now.
Keep moving! Keep moving!
Seconds to go, halfway through round 8. Not what he was looking for. That's a miss right there by Chico. Gonzalez has got to figure out a way to do something different here. I mean, I know he's committed to being a counterpuncher. Good power punch. The right hand landed. Hey, I know he's not in great shape, but he's doing a very good job now, all of a sudden, of defending himself.
There you go. Come on.
Oh, that's gotta hurt.
know where they got that saying, falling like a sack of potatoes.
Gonzalez is rising back up. That takes some guts.
Move your head.
Beat him to the punch.
Work with somebody.
Keep pushing.
We come to the end of this round, and for this fighter, I think that's a good thing because I was looking at him there, Teddy, and it looked like he was breathing in and out of his mouth for most of that round.
Yeah, and that's a bad sign. That means that the gas tank is a little low. He's low on petrol.
Looking good, looking good. He's tired. He's tired. He's got nothing left. I need you to double up your punches and keep the lead, all right?
Start of a new round, but will it be much the same? Gonzalez has been down numerous times tonight, Teddy.
Well, if there was a mercy rule like there is in Little League Baseball, guess what? It would be invoked right now, and this would be over.
Nice block. And he's holding. Clinching his opponent. Nobody likes to see that.
That's it, just like that.
Not able to land the headshot.
Let's go.
Nice block that time. It was intended to the head.
One, two.
Chico's just a completely different fighter now. I mean, he was stunned earlier in this fight, and since then, there's just more of a defensive disposition to him.
Yeah, and the important thing right now is that sooner or later, and I think it's going to be sooner.
What a big shot. Gonzalez is down, and he may be out. Chico's night has ended early here. Unable to go the distance, he couldn't rise up and beat the count. That's how you end a fight right there. Yes, he was controlling throughout, but he made a good, clean finish with the knockout.
Yeah, as a trainer, you want to know, can a guy punch? Can a guy defend? You know, can a guy control distance? But you want to know, can a guy finish? He got the answer. Yes, he can finish.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Have yourself a great night.